Hey yo, what's up guys, my name is Anvit and you're watching Hacks and Geeks. This is the second part of building Lineage OS, and in the previous video I had shown you how to set up Ubuntu in a virtual machine. If you haven't watched it yet, then I'll put the link for that video in the description and also in the YouTube cards above. So make sure to check that out. And in this part, I'll be showing you guys how to download the sources, then setting up the build environment, and finally I'll be building Lineage OS for any device. So let's begin by opening the terminal in the Ubuntu virtual machine that we had set up. Now type wget followed by this URL, and all these commands will be listed in the blog post, for which you can find the links below in the description, so that you can easily copy paste these instead of typing a whole bunch of commands. Once you enter the command, it will download ADB platform tools. Then you can extract these files by following unzip command. Now you have to edit the profile file in Ubuntu. You can do this by typing the following sudo gedit command, and then you have to add these lines of code at the end of the file in the open text editor. Then save and close the file. Now run the source profile command. After that, you have to download and install whole bunch of packages, which can simply be done by running the given apt install command, and then type y and hit enter to confirm the installation. Once done, you have to create two directories, which you can do by running the following mkdir commands. If you go to the file manager, you'll find that the folders will be created there. Now you have to download a tool called repo, which will let you sync the source code of Lineage OS. You can do that by the following curl command, and then you have to grant permission by using chmod a+x command. Again, you have to edit the profile file by using sudo gedit profile command, and then you have to add the following lines of code if it doesn't exist. But usually, this code will already be there in the latest version of Ubuntu, so enter these only if it doesn't have these codes. Mine already has this, so I'm skipping this step by closing the file. If you had changed anything in this file, you can run the source profile command. Now you have to change the working directory to the newly created folder, which can be done by typing cd android/system. And now you have to initialize the Lineage OS repo by running the repo init command. Here, as we are building Lineage OS 14.1, we enter cm14.1 at the end. But if you want to build for any other version, you can do that by changing the branch, like making it cm13.0 or something like that. Now you will get an error saying that you have to configure your email address and the username. You can do that by the following commands, and by changing the email to your email address and the username to your name. Once done, again type the repo init command and then press Y to enable the color display, and then the repo will be initialized. Now you have to type repo sync. This will take a lot of time depending upon your internet connection, as it will be downloading all the source code, and the download size may be around 15 to 30 gigabytes. So it's better to keep this at night. Finally, once it's downloaded, type source build /env setup.sh. Now type breakfast following with your device codename. I'm building Lineage OS for OnePlus One, which is codename beacon, so I'll type breakfast beacon and then hit enter. This will download your device specific configuration and kernel. Now you have to turn on cache by entering this command, and also you have to paste this code in your bashrc file by using sudo gedit command, and then save and exit the file. Next, you have to set cache size using the below command. If you are building Lineage OS for just one device, then you can set about 25 to 50 gigabyte of cache disk space. But if you are building it for multiple devices, then at least target 75 to 100 gigabyte of cache disk space. Jack is a new compiler used in Lineage 14.1, but it always runs out of memory. So to fix this, run the following command. And also Add this command at the end of your bashrc file to configure it automatically. Plus, you can also run this command to enable optional cache compression, but this may result in a tiny performance slowdown, but it increases the number of files that fit in your cache. Now it's finally time to build Lineage OS. First type CROOT and then type branch following with your device codename. As said, I'm building Lineage OS for OnePlus One, which is codename Beacon. So I'll type branch Beacon and hit enter. This will take a lot of time and your CPU power. If the build is successful, you'll get an obvious message stating that the build was successful. Now, you can find the completed build file in your Android /system/out/target/product, and then inside your device folder, you'll find the completed unofficial Lineage OS build file. So I guess that's it for this part, guys, and in the next part, I'll be showing how to fix the common errors that you may face. So make sure to check the blog post which is linked below, and also all the links for other parts of this video will be linked under the description. Thank you for watching the video, guys. I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, then a like rating will be awesome. For more videos from us, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and I'll see you in the next one. Goodbye.